better than. This is a kid whose parents were fiercely protective of her and did their best to break up a fledgling romance between her and my father. Parents that sent her away to a private school, high school, which actually was what formed my mother. Oakwood School in Poughkeepsie, New York, was where she found herself. And I had the pleasure of going back in 2010 to visit with her, and got to see where her room was. It's now part of the administration building. So I got to see the general assembly room where the Quakers would talk things out.
Or be quiet.
And this is where she became a kind of an independent cuss, because she's always been registered as an independent voter. As a result, I think, of the high school years. So, you know, high school could be a very formative time. And then, you know, adapting to that type of early childhood and young teenage background to the Hoffman-Wolfberg family is what I think created the ability for her to raise five children, because she went from a very small family to a very large family that lived kind of in a family compound in West Philadelphia for many, many years. And seeing how a large family acted with each other, I think, gave her some confidence maybe to start popping us out.
Daddy said I wanted 10 kids. I said no, I didn't say that.
One of the things I remember as a younger child was the, and this had to have been, I think, your idea. I've never talked to you about this, but all of you met us when we first moved to California in the early 1970s. But how do you break that to your five kids, that you're in the middle of the school year, you're going to be moving across the country for this great adventure, which none of us thought it was going to be at the time. But I remember you and Dad sitting down in the bedroom in Beechwood with me and Dan, because we were sharing a room, talking about how exciting California is, and wouldn't it be kind of cool to go there. And then you came back a couple days later to kind of, you already planted the seed, and then you broke the news that we're moving there. And I figured that had to have been kind of the way the pediatric nurse might have been thinking about breaking this to the kids that could follow it and understand it. But you've always had that touch with all of us, one way or another, to be able to figure out how we need to be talked to, how we need to be responded to, how we need to be loved. So our love back to you. Thank you for bringing us on this great adventure.
Do I have great kids or what?